Richard Clark, team captain from Cycling for Comrades, is on the line just now. Good afternoon, Richard. How are you doing?
Good afternoon. Yeah, I'm fine. Thanks very much.
Good stuff. I've heard all about Cycling for Comrades, but know very little about it. Can you enlighten us? What's it all about?
Essentially, it's four ex-serving soldiers. There's also an individual from the Royal Navy who are attempting to beat the current RAM record. The RAM is the race across America. It's basically a 3,000-mile bike race, and it's all in aid of three very important and worthwhile service charities: Horseback UK, Poppy Scotland, and Combat Stress.
Wow. It sounds like an amazing challenge. What do you have to do in terms of preparation?
Well, it takes a year to train to get us to the level that we would need to be, whilst it isn't a professional race by any stretch. In fact, a lot of volunteers and a lot of people who wish to raise money for charities similar to what we are use this as a platform to do that. We'll start training. We've already started, to be honest, and we will continue to train all the way up until June the 15th next year when the race starts.
So this is called the RAM Challenge, yeah? Where and when is it?
It's the 15th of June 2013, and it will start on the west coast of America at a place called Oceanside Terminal, and we'll see us travel 3,000 miles to a place called Annapolis on the east coast of America.
Oh my goodness, I mean, how much ground do you have to cover in a day to complete the challenge?
Well, the hope, the aspiration is that we'll be able to cover as close to 600 miles a day in a team of four. Not everyone in the team, it's a relay race.
Right.
So the hope is that we'll be able to cover as much as 600 miles in a day, and that will get us somewhat on the nose for the current record, which is about 5 days, 9 hours.
So you're talking on average 150 miles across what's going to be really rather warm terrain at that time. Every day.
Yeah, pretty much.
Now, Richard, you serve in the Black Watch just now. You've been with the Black Watch nearly 12 years. Do you think that's helped prepare you in some ways for this type of challenge?
I think it's helped generate my enthusiasm and sort of motivation for doing it. I've done a couple of events prior to this, and I suppose rather than just keep doing what I know I can do, I'm always trying to challenge myself and those that are willing to become sort of volunteers on my team. I want to make sure that we're doing everything we can for the money that we are intending to raise.
Always good to aim high. Who again is going to benefit from the money that you do raise?
Well, the three very important charities, and the fact is they will be well known. Poppy Scotland is a huge charity across the country. It sort of helps the veterans and indeed serving soldiers by offering grants. Horseback UK has been about for a little while, and to a certain extent is somewhat lesser known than the other charities, but it provides support for injured soldiers in the form of sort of the use of equine therapy, and then Combat Stress, which is a huge charity and deals with the mental aspects of injuries for veterans specifically.
I mean, you're using this as a two-pronged approach. You're aiming to raise awareness as well for those who've been affected mentally by witnessing conflict. What kind of issues do people face?
It's huge. There's an unnecessary stigma attached to post-traumatic stress disorder, and what that means is sometimes veterans feel they can't come forward with the emotions that they're feeling, and sometimes it goes unseen and unheard. So my challenge is to try and raise awareness, to get rid of the stigma that's unfortunately attached to post-traumatic stress disorder, as well as anxiety attacks, etc. And I hope that this challenge will help bring it to the fore.
Yeah, definitely hope so. Richard, you're no stranger to helping others. I was reading you had a previous venture. Was it last year or the year before where you raised a significant sum of money? Can you tell us about that?
I was involved with Tartan Casino, which was the biggest one I'd done to date. Basically, I was able with my team, very much with my team. I wasn't able to do it alone, but we cycled from Casino in Italy through the north of Italy, Switzerland, France, and through the UK. As I say, we managed to raise £28,000, and we were very grateful for the support we received all the way through, in fact, all the way through Europe, and especially coming up the Royal Mail when we got into Edinburgh.
It sounds like you certainly worked for your money, though, that's for sure. Back to the race across America, can you tell me a bit about your team for this one?
There's four ex-serving soldiers, who two of which have been involved with Tartan Casino, and again, they want to put themselves through the pain, if you like, of the race across America. And the other is a former serving officer of the Black Watch, who is obviously heard about what I was planning to do and was keen to get on board. We've got eight volunteers from the UK, and we're also going to have four American volunteers who will sort of provide the vehicle assistance and navigational support and stuff.
Finally, Richard, how can the people of Dunfermline and West Fife find out a bit more about what you're doing and indeed help you with the challenge?
initially, I would advise them to go to Facebook and look up Team C4C and like it, share it, and let everybody know exactly what it is we're intending to do. Whilst the £150,000 target is huge, it is huge, and I fully accept that, the awareness is my priority. If we could get 10,000 likes in a year, I think we'll do a great amount for those guys out there who are unfortunately suffering in silence because of the stigma attached to PTSD and anxiety.
And of course, there's your website as well. We've put a link on our Facebook page. Can you remind us of that one? I've forgotten myself.
Yeah, it's cyclingforcomrades.co.uk. The website that's there at the moment will be getting changed slightly. However, all the details of what we're trying to achieve are on that website. And
Richard, thanks for coming on to Radio West Fife this afternoon, and all the best with the challenge.
Thanks very much for your time. Appreciate it. Cheers, bye.